Thank you. There's more.
There are many.
Like many?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
You're not in front.
We are going to be together through this course.
be like.
I have a weird
will thinking, I have a weird will writing questions. I don't know what happened, but that's how it is. So what I want you guys to do is you need to work with me. You need to think with me. You need to think like, you can't think like me, but try to understand the way I think. So one way how you are going to do well in my exam is that as I teach, I know I ask questions. So the questions that I ask, you need to, that's the way I ask my normal questions during the exam. So get to know my way of asking, and my way of responding to what is going to happen at that point in your world. So, I may not bring in things that are going to be projected here or that are going to teach, but I would want you to apply your thinking. Because by the end of the day, you're going to go out there and
be somebody else.
Be a person that when you're here, you're going to go for it.
I like the way she did.
And when you ask them, you don't even know it yourself, but because it's been given, you train yourself in that way. So, can we start?
Well, maybe the reason I think and today is like, oh, maybe I didn't. We didn't think that.
No, it's okay.
Okay.
when you're guiding someone, who is taking the lead?
You.
The guider. Someone is still being guided. When you are enlightening someone, when there is an enlightenment happening, what is the whole picture here?
I had to enlighten him. I had to enlighten him. What did you do? It's like trying to make someone see things that you're seeing that they can't see. Trying to make them do things that they don't know.
Trying to make them do things that they don't know. All right. What about enlightening? Suppose this room has got it's dark. Then I bring it. When I was about to say, please show me somebody a way out. Like, to make them think in a positive way that they can get out of something.
Mm-hmm.
You just put everything in perspective.
Yeah.
Alright, so here is Kambi. She's right at the corner. It's dark. She wants to come out, but she can't. Oh, Kimberly, Dad is bringing a girl. So she's going to maneuver and then she goes out. You're not making a decision for them, but you're simply trying to put everything in perspective to say, here is what it is. Choose what you want.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. So as we go, we are going to see what counseling is all about. At some point, you will hear that counseling is not about telling you what to do. At some point, we are going to learn to say it is okay to tell them that this is the way. But however, the choice remains with the person being counseled. So, when we are talking about counseling psychology, it is a special area within the science and professional psychology. Counseling psychology is within the professional or specialty area within science and professional or psychology. Alright, so what we are going to do is we want to see what happened, who started the whole idea of counseling psychology. So what I'm about to say now is a bit of a history, which you may want to listen. And you can do it if you want to, okay? But it's just for you to know where are we coming from. Alright, so counseling psychology. Image shortly after World War II. So after World War II, there was what do we mean by mental vision? Right, after all this, has happened. Where is this one and where is this one? So the effect would have been different. So there was a need for someone to measure, to say how much damage has been caused in this human being as this one and this one. But at the same time, how do we take care of everything else that has happened? So after that, that's why now we have these movements. There were several of them. We are going to look at some of them in detail. So when we are talking about counseling, we are talking about a mutual relationship between a counselor. When we are talking about a counselor, we are talking about someone who has been professionally trained and a client. This client can also be only one human. But it has to be a mutual relationship. What is counseling? Counseling is a mutual relationship between the counselor, who is a professional trainer or helper, and the client, who is also known as a consumer or a business. So this definition was defined in 2002 by UNESCO. Alright, so far, before I go on, because this is the first time for us to meet, I would want you to find out, are you okay with the way I am explained? Are you able to follow? Okay. So, when we are talking about counseling, it is a learning-oriented process, which occurs usually in an interactive relationship. It is a learning-oriented process. Learning-oriented process, which occurs usually in an interactive relationship. The aim of this interactive relationship is to help someone learn more about them. Learning-oriented process that happens in an interactive relationship, which results in someone learning more about themselves. Okay, so when a person has learned more about themselves, then the person is going to become, or he's going to be able to understand the knowledge that has been imparted. When you have understood yourself, you are going to use that understanding to rectify yourself. And in the process, you become a member of the society. So, learning-oriented process, that involves interaction and relationship. That results in learning more about them. When you learn about yourself, you use the understanding. And when you use the understanding, you become an effective member of the society. That's the whole process, or that's the whole reason why Counselling Psychology is there. It is a learning-oriented process which occurs usually in an interactive relationship with the aim of helping a person to learn more about self and to use such an understanding to enable the person to become an effective member of the society. Right. People are individuals, but by the end of the day, they become part of the whole. So if someone has been affected in one way or the other. They are not going to spend their whole day within or their whole life within the house. They will somehow go out, interact with people, whether they are going to school, whether they are going to work, whether they are going to church, but they will still find themselves in a presence of one person, two persons, or so on. So it is at this time when now we can arrange to say this person is useless, or this person is effective, or this person is distracting at this time. So why is psychology, counseling psychology is coming in? It is to make sure that whatsoever is happening to whoever, wherever they are, it has to make them to become effective members of society. So in other words, counseling psychology is there to clean the environment. So, counseling psychology is provided under a variety of levels. Counseling psychology, in other words, maybe I will say example of counseling psychology. So, it is provided under several levels. For example, there are instances where counseling is offered when the relationship is primarily focused on other. Have that kind of I would say. We are not going to invent into the actual counseling relationship, but counseling is going to be there. I'll give you an example of someone's time. I have a student who was online, and she kept missing sessions. So I would chase after her until when I see the end and tired. I'm not the one I want to learn. I'm going to try for the last time. So I tried it, she was not there. I made an initiative to call her, and then she said, we do the research, but I'm not the host. So because of where we're coming from, I thought she was just. I said, okay, when you're done at the hospital, I want to come there and meet you. I want to see you again. And then she said, oh, all right. After she finished, she called me, I was there, she was not lying. She had a daughter, but about 2 years. And she said, since my daughter was born, she never had proper school, she was what I was about. So maybe her school has said she shouldn't go anymore because they think it's contagious, she may have to go to other people and so on. So she was psychologically affected. Then I understood, I said, right. Looking at your daughter, if you ask me, she has been. You're telling me for 2 years you've been doing this, but when I look at her, she doesn't see. And then she looked at me like, yeah, you don't. What do you mean? I said, she's not. What did the doctor tell me? The doctor now has advised that I'll be trying to take her to India. So I said, right, you know what? We are going to pray. Why? The second thing is, I'm going to tell you that stop giving your child that. Stop giving your child anything that has got milk in it. What does she take when she's going to school? Enjoy. I said, no, stop enjoying, stop more, stop. What do you I get my list of things to do. Don't allow her to take this anymore. So here we are. We're talking and then she looked
like she gave up.
So she went home, first day class. The second day she called and said, you know what, for the first time, who jumps over who? But she didn't.
Like, yeah, it came to my tears.
Counselling psychologist. So, counselling psychology, they engage in many of the same activities as clinical psychologists. So, we've got the counselling ones and we've got clinical psychologists. So, counselling psychologists engage in many of the same activities as clinical psychologists. But these ones, they focus on normative. They focus on normative function.
Counselling psychologists, normally you find a
So, they help people on how to manage it in their life. So, life issues, we're talking of transition. We manage everyday life issues as well as transitions. These are companies that help the people to manage their everyday life issues as well as transitions. So, there are a lot of things or issues that are happening in your daily life. There are just things that you want that happen. There are others when that happens, they don't, it doesn't go well with them. Others have been a career change. Think that actually something happened, you need someone to take it through. You talk about college, from secondary school to college. That period where you don't know what is going to happen with my life. I'm talking about the 7 point. There's no government in the rest of the land going to teach me. My parents don't have enough money. My parents don't have enough money to take me to see you and so on and so forth. So that's fair. For others, it is very fluid. You need someone to take you through. Unfortunately, in Malawi, we don't take it seriously. That is why whenever I'm talking to you guys, you have got a lot of space out there where you can arrange your office and put it there. Social worker and your special thing. Where you're now going to bring in all these things.
Alright, remember we talked about counseling emerging after the Second World War?